On today's episode, I'm going to be building up AMT's 1966 Buick Wildcat. This is a 3-in-1 kit. You can build it stock, custom, or show. We're going to show all the parts, but check out, you've got a ton of customizing parts. You've got different style ideas on the outside of the box. You can go with a stock option. You can go with a full custom. You can go with a show rod or any mix in between. Let's start looking at all the parts that are in the box. This time we'll start out on the opposite side of the desk. We'll lay a bunch of stuff out there and bring up the huge decal sheet. This has got all kinds of options on it for drag cars, custom cars, work vehicles. Definitely save these, because if you're not going to use them on this car, you've got some really cool ideas for everything else, and we'll come all the way out there so you can see all the cool stuff. I don't see any decals in here for dash gauges or anything like that, or body emblems, but it does have a lot of custom stuff on there. We've got a nice baggie here with the giant front and back glass as one piece. I do like that. It makes my model simpler. We got some red tinted plastic, which is always a help. We got two little steel axles in the box, so we don't forget about those. The tires on this thing are very unique to me. They've got Firestone Supremes on one side in a yellow gold font, which look awesome, with that simple bias ply tread. And then we've got white walls on the other side. They're like 2-in-1 tires in a 3-in-1 kit, so you can turn them either way you want. I really like the look of those. I'm going to see if I can use them, because that's the first time I've seen those. And you'll get four of those. They're not hollow. They are solid tires. We've got a good amount of chrome. Check out these dish-style wheels in more of a rougher chrome. I kind of like that look. Not the overly super shiny, but more of a cast chrome. We got our lace wheels. We've got all kinds of optional grills. We got our stock front end here. We've got our stock wheels here. That little shifter even says Hurst on the side. We've got carburation. We've got the giant chrome fancy lake pipes on it. We got our stock tail. We've got dressed up valve covers. You can get a better look at that front end in stock trim. We got our custom front end, custom grills in there and back ends. All kinds of awesome parts in that chrome tree. We'll switch to the other side, start throwing the white plastic out here. We've got that. We've got custom parts. Let's take a look at this. We've got part of our bodywork here. We've got our firewall, which is highly detailed. We've got one of the custom hoods. Kind of like a cowl hood without any openings on it. That's interesting. And they go through and do the full bracing underneath at the same time. We've got another custom front end. Almost looks like a Charger front end, doesn't it? Custom body pieces. We've got our rear end. We've got body panels. We've got wheel backs, which are our fin to look like drums. We've got our wheel pins, it looks like. We've got our V8 here. There are some option engines, but there is only one engine transmission combo included. But you saw in the chrome parts, you do have dress up and intake options on this thing. We got our belt and pulley system. We got manifolds, headers, exhaust pipes, fans, air cleaner, intake, all kinds of cool parts. We got a little battery right there. What else we got going on? Let's get this out here. Two more hoods. We got our stock hood here, which says Buick and has a hole punched for the hood ornament. That's our stock hood with detail underneath and wheel backs. We've got two sets of bucket seats, stock and custom. And we've got a really nice custom hood here with vents in it. Also stamped in it says fuel injection on the side of each one. Nice looking custom hood. This one's my favorite so far of the hoods. I really like the look of that. We've got our dashboard here with some pretty strong details on it. I'll be able to use my silver pencil, and we'll go over that as always to show it. And our stock steering wheel. Nice huge dashboard on this thing. It's even got a vent up there. Big, big, big. And the last chunks of styrene are the biggest. Look at the size of that body. Enormous. The trim is nice and prominent. The door lines, the door handles are all nice and prominent on this, so it won't be hard to detail. Those of you who like Molotow chrome, those of me that like silver pens, all that stuff should be quite easy to detail this. We've got some supports we can take out so that we don't break our little trim there. cut out the hood support. You gotta leave this big one in. Underneath, we can see where we locate our interior. Nice looking body there. The underpan shows its promo roots. We got one piece suspension, exhaust, differential, and everything. But you can easily hand detail that. It's not going to be a problem. We got our fuel tank. It actually is quite nicely detailed, as you can see, from underneath. And on the top is just basic detail that we'll be spraying anyway. And the big interior tub, the length of that thing. Look at that. 3/4 of a hand, of a big hand. We got nice detail on that tub. It's enormous, so you can get in there. They've got like kind of a quilted texture here. We've got nice door handle features, pedals, center console, all nicely detailed and ready to go. I'm going to start assembly and we'll be right back. My buddy Gary told me this was a nice simple kit and he was completely correct. We've got some things going on here. All of this right here, 45 minutes folks, 45 minute build time. That's all it takes. We got that nice engine put together. We got the distributor on, we got the exhaust on. I'll be hand painting it all because this is an older promo style kit. And you know what? I enjoy doing the hand painting and messing with it. You can see, of course, it's got the big hole belying its older nature of the promo style for the front axle. So if you wanted to fill that hole, it'd be a nice engine to use in other kits. Otherwise, it's going to look absolutely fine underneath the hood of this monster Wildcat. It's got great detail on it. Engine and transmission, got that nice intake with the individual runners coming off of it and everything for the dual quads. So that's a nice motor to build up. Our dashboard looks lovely. I'm just going to get the chance to put some paint on it, so I cut the tree free. Same with our steering wheel. We got those cut free so I can paint them. And we cut the two stock bucket seats free so I can get those painted. Little something I learned, these aren't wheel pins. These are body attachment points. When the chassis goes underneath, instead of using screws, this will just go up there and you will press those pins in place into those holes right there. And that's how you'll attach the body. I already test fit the interior and everything just kind of pops right in. We'll look at that in a second. So these are our stock brake drum wheel backs. This is your optional steering wheel right there. And these are your body attachment points. So we'll be painting all those up as we go. The interior really doesn't need any work. I just have to clean up the seam on the front and that is it. We'll watch how that goes in. So easy. Once you have it all glued together, you'll just slide it in from the back and align it with those two holes and push them down. A little bit of glue, your interior will be held in. Check out that huge package shelf. You could store some of your apartment in there. Rent it out to some college kids. So the interior will go in and out easy. The firewall mounts in super easy. You've got these location areas here. These pins, you can see it's a little forward of those right now. Why? Because while the glue is still wet, I want you to put your interior in and slide it forward and pin it in like that so those pins are lined up. Your firewall is flush against the body, and now we know everything is exactly where it should be for the hood to line up in the back and everything. We know that we're all set. So I love these simplified kits. I really do it. I don't need anything to be complicated. I just love the clean lines and the simple look of everything. All I have to do is just cut out this fender brace here from the mold process, and we are ready to get that into paint. The underbody needs no work whatsoever. I am going to use the vented hood. I love it. But I'm using two carburetors, so fuel injection on either side of the hood didn't make any sense. Took some sanding sticks that you get for doing nails from the dollar store and sanded that fuel injection off each side. So now we have a beautiful smooth hood. I can chrome out the intake on there, and that's going to be like a nice, cool custom car. I've also got the belt and pulley system done. The alternator is in chrome, so we'll leave that alone. We got our battery. These are the outlets from the exhaust if you're going to use the huge lake pipes along the bottom of the body. I'm not going to be using those, but they're on the tree with the air cleaner. I'm doing kind of a stock-ish build, mild custom. The car's, you know, 7-8 years old. The kid has it. He's going to make it look a little nicer, put a cooler hood on it and stuff like that. From this tree, we're not going to be using a whole lot. We're going to be using the stock rear and the stock grill. And I think I like the stock wheels. I mean, they are really attractive wheels in real life. almost every manufacturer made wheels that look like that. So I think I like them, but I haven't decided yet. I can always decide later whether I want to go with these laced wheels or if I want to go with the stock ones. I'm definitely using the Hurst shifter because there's not a teenager in the world that wouldn't use that if they had it available. And the two carburetors, the hood ornament won't get used, so we'll have a whole bunch of stuff left over on the chrome tree. I'm going to get everything over into paint. Come along with me.
Thank you.
using some very simple tools that anyone can get a hold of. You can make a promo model that doesn't have massive amounts of fine, intricate detail, look pretty good, and definitely be a nice shelf model for display. You can see I like my white interiors. I did a black carpet on this one to go with the black dashboard instead of going like a dark blue, like the body and the dark blue dash. Did some very minor chrome accents on the door panels. I did go with the Hurst shifter, blackwashed around the base of it, and then did that metallic with Molotow in the back and blackwashed it a little bit. So we've got a nice basic interior that will go in and look absolutely fine. What I did in the creases of the seats is I used some light gray Tamiya Paneline accent color. They have blacks, light grays, grays, browns, and all that. Model Roundup does carry those now because I've been using them and they know that people want to get a hold of them. So we've got some nice door panel detail and that's all set to go. The dashboard I did up with my silver pens. Now I've shown how to do these a gajillion times, so I decided to skip it in this video and you can just check out another video. I covered some other stuff as well. I'd use a silver pencil. This one just happens to be a Prismacolor Premier brand, Hobby Lobby. It looks like it was $1.99. And I sharp and I rub in on the raised gauge faces, and that makes them stand out. White for me doesn't seem to work as well, and silver really makes them stand out and they look good. So that's what I've been using when I do those. You can see how they pop out. For the rest of the silver accents, a nice Kaiser gel pen, also from Hobby Lobby where I grabbed it, and those go on nicely and do all the way around the dashboard and the radio and all the details, and that gives us a nice looking dash. I also did the trim on the steering wheel with the exact same pen, and those work lovely. Saw me paint in the exhaust and the fuel tank on the car. That's just a very basic underbody. Nothing really to work on down there. You could always dry brush that, weather it up, do whatever you wanted. We got the grills and the wheels done. The wheels, I used my Tester's metallic graphite, brush painted it in, and you can see how it sinks into the detail, and then use Q-tips to brush it off, and those wheels are gonna look great when they're dry. For the grills, you saw me use my Tester's, or my Tamiya, Paneline accent color in black, and now you can see how that stands out really nice. The headlights stick out as bright. We have the underlying areas and that grill darkened out. Did the same for the taillights. Just have to snap those red taillights in and glue them into place. We'll see that later. Those are set to go. The engine is all done and ready to drop in. Very basic details using craft paints, Tester silvers, Tester's graphite metallic on the manifolds. You can see that that turns out to be just a nice engine. It's got the hole in there for the axle, but when it's sitting in the car like so, it's going to be absolutely fine. So we are really moving along on here. There is not much left to do at all. I have to glue the glass into the body. You can check out the trim that I did. A mixture of the Molotow pens that you can get at Model Roundup and Sharpie silver markers you can get anywhere. Got the accents on there. Detailed it. So we're coming along fine on that body. That's looking good. With the trim and everything around the wheel wells and along the doors, I have to put the glass in that, and then the body is pretty much done. We'll get the dashboard in. You can actually see how nice it's going to look once we drop that in there. Check that out. That will be a nice interior, classy Buick, ready to cruise. Got to get the grills pushed on and everything. I even went ahead, since I had the time, and painted the radiator black, even though, I mean, it's not too realistic, but so what? We're going to be going opening the hood so we can look at it. It's an old promo, but that doesn't mean you can't have some fun detailing it. I haven't decided yet whether I want to use white walls or the yellow letters. Now, I do like those white walls and I do like the yellow letters. I think I'm going to do one wheel up each way, put it underneath the body, see what I like, and then make my final decision. So when I get the interior all set in the body, just before we're ready to button everything up, I'll come back once more. Pick my wheel and tire package. You can see I went with the white walls on there. I just kept looking at them and looking at them, and I thought, yeah, darker colored metallic blue body with the nice chrome wheels, with the very subtle trim on the inside of those wheels. The white walls are what we're going to go with on this one. The interior is all ready to go, so we will stick that in the body right now. I don't even think it's going to require glue. Being the promo style, it goes together. That big Buick V8 underneath the hood with the dual quads, the chrome valve covers. I did a little black washing inside those valve covers to make them shine up. Glued the battery in place, and that's a nice looking unit. Now the wheels and tires do move a little bit in here with the engine, especially in the back, but they do fit underneath the body. I've already dry fitted it, so I shouldn't need to cut anything off the axles. Sometimes you need to cut down those metal axles on these, but I shouldn't need to. I gloss coated over the flat black to give me that nice sheen on the air cleaner. That'll be ready to go. Our headlights and tail lights are pressed together. Those are ready to go. The grill looks awesome. Got our turn signals lightly tinted, not a real strong tint on there, but that grill looks sweet. Did some black wash in the hood. That is still drying, actually. I brush on some future floor polish. It's called Pledge Revive now or something like that. So when I get done with the whole car as well, I'll be brushing another coat over the whole thing, glass and all. So what I have to do at this point is put the interior in the body. Let's do that right now. Just like we showed earlier, it just kind of goes under. We already had our glass in there. Don't forget your glass. And then, while it's on camera, it probably won't go super easy. But those two pins back there, there we go. It's a friction fit. And now our interior is inside the body. And that will press up. I love that white package shelf back there. I love that look of a white interior on a darker colored car. I think that looks tough, and the dashboard looks great up underneath there. So all I need to do then is put the body down over the chassis, use these pins to push it in place, attach my front and rear bumpers, push the hood down, put the air cleaner over the motor, and we will have a final. See you in just a second. Here we are at the final for the 66 Buick Wildcat 125th scale 3-in-1 kit from the folks at Round 2 Models through AMT. They sent this over for review. We thank them a lot. This kit is out right now. I will link in the description to where you can get yours. What's not to like about it? All right, it's huge. For one thing, it's a giant boat of a car. It builds super easy. This could easily be a first glue kit for anyone. If you haven't built a glue kit in 40 years, 30 years, 20 years, 10 years, or 10 minutes, this is an easy one to pick up and get your mojo back. It's just enough stuff to keep it nicely detailed. I mean, it's got the engine in it with the axle across the front of it, but who cares? You can barely see it when it's under the hood anyways when the hood's off. It's got option parts galore. You can decorate it up like I have. I love my color combination, that deep metallic blue with the vents in the hood, with the white wall tires to go with the white interior. The little Hurst shifter is an excellent spare part for anything. And even on a promo style model, the dashboard is nice. Yes, it goes together very simplistic. The chassis and driveline are all in one part, and it doesn't matter. With a little bit of painting and picking out, it looks nice. The exhaust is all in there, all the molds prominent. It's really easy to do the trim work. The bumpers fit on nicely. The grills, they don't have a problem. You don't have to fight them. They don't fall off. You just glue them in place. The trim is prominent, so you can practice doing trim work on it and have a good time with that. You can try bare metal foil. You can try Molotow pens. You can stick with silver Sharpies that I like. You get these nice wheels. You also get all these optional parts. You know, you could work like this kind of a grill, this flat piece. You could work that into other kits. You could work these lake pipes into other kits. Definitely the wheels are usable with other kits. You get this whole extra set of chrome smoothies in the kit. You get this extra intake. You got the hood ornament. You got the headers on there. You got all kinds of stuff. And if you build a stock one, you have a gajillion decals left over. And I love the municipal decals. We're probably going to see those again in some sort of review in the future, because there's some very nice service garage, paint shop, detailing logos on there that are really sweet. So we've got all kinds of stuff in this kit, and yet you can get this done on a weekend. You and the kids can build this up, get the grandson, the granddaughter, get the son, the niece, the nephew, put it all together and have an awesome time with it and end up with a really nice model like I have here. And it's going to look great on the shelf. It's going to take up some space. You get to practice all kind of detailing. You can weather this bad boy out. There's all different ways you could go with this and not have to put a lot of time into it or worry about a super fancy extra detail kit that no one's going to see in the end anyways. So there will be pictures at the end of the video as always, so you can see underneath the hood and the detail without it spinning around. I really like the kit. I've never seen it before, of course, like most of these. I'm glad I went with the vents in the hood. It just adds that little bit of extra muscle with that super Wildcat engine underneath the hood. And we will see you at the next review.